Okay, welcome to the show, ladies and gentlemen. Skaggy Bones, I'm your host, and we're going to be doing a little bit of maintenance on our bike today. Not any heavy stuff, mostly. We've been on to a couple long rides here recently, and the chain has gotten a little dirty. Let me zoom in here if I can. There we go. Sorry about the shakiness. Zoom in. You can kind of see there, chain has gotten it's getting dirty. One of the first things you can do if you are worried about a worn chain is we got our chain checker tool right here. There you go, as you can see here. And I'm going to give you a quick demonstration how we do that. You come here to the top portion of it. We're going to check with 0.5, and we're going to come hook in like so. Come down. It's not even going into 0.5, so we know it's definitely not going to go 1.75. So yeah, not even dropping down in there. Once it drops down into 0.5 area, let's see here, we'll focus. Once it drops down in that 0.5 area, I would at least pick up another chain and have it on standby, and then once it goes down into that 0.75, it is most definitely time to replace the chain. So we're not in that case yet. I haven't put that many miles on this chain, so we should be good to go. But one of the first things that we want to do, and I'm going to get my trusty gloves on, and I'm going to zoom out for you folks. I want you to be able to see the whole picture here. I'm going to get my trusty work gloves on, just because if I don't like to mess up my hands and get them all greasy. You can use other types of gloves as well. Always have myself down a couple of paper bags or something down on the floor, just for cases like this. Of course, one of the first things we want to do is we want to take this to the lowest gear. Okay, now I'm going to take it to the lowest gear, and then I can reach around back. Oh, sorry, take your brake lever to the off position. There is a switch up here, and on the other side, you guys can't see it, but on the other side there's this little lever. You're going to flip it to the up position. That's going to release the brake. Then you can release your quick release. And if you don't have quick release, if you have just a through axle because you have disc brakes, you can do it that way too. You should know how to do it. And then we're going to take off our thing here, and I'm going to be pulling this guy apart and cleaning the cassette. Okay, so it's taken quite a beating the last couple days, and I want to just clean her off. Now, this is a little bit more than most people are going to do for basic, I don't want to say basic cleaning, but there's some, I want to clean the bottom bracket bearings and some other stuff like that. So I'm going to come around back here, and I'm going to get my guy here to drop out. Okay. And remember, with this quick release, it doesn't have to go any specific way. You're not trying to be fancy on it. There's gonna come in. Guy up, bring it into the quick relief, into the dropout, like so, and then you'll have that right there. And then you can bring that up one notch. For some reason it doesn't sit very good on the lowest notch the way this spark tool piece is. Okay, so we're going to be doing that. The next thing that we want to do is I'm going to be taking these crank arms off because I want to be able to clean in here. I got some dirt and stuff inside the aft section here. So you can kind of see here, I'm going to spin the bike around a little bit and try to. So what's happened is I got a lot of dirt and debris and stuff in here that I want to take care of. So I'm pretty much going to pop the crank arms off. And one of the ways you want to first do that is you want to take this, you can do it one of two ways. You can take it off by, you can remove the chain altogether if you have a quick links, which somewhere you should. Yep, I got a quick links right here, so I can remove the chain, clean the chain separate if I really want to, and give it a good scrub down, and then clean the rest of this, but that's not really my plan right now. My plan is I'm going to wipe all this down, get it all degreased and cleaned off. So I'm going to bring this into the lower like so, and then I'm going to come over here and I'm going to pull tension from the rear derailleur, and I'm going to take the chain off and I'm going to drape it onto the bottom bracket right there like that, and it'll just hang loose. Don't worry about damaging the bottom bracket area like that, okay? So now I'm going to spin this guy. Now, a couple tools that you're going to need, you really don't need this piece here. It's not a necessity to use, but I find it tends to be handy. They do come in handy. Okay, now that I got most of that done, take my gloves off. Need to get a pair of. They make these nitrile gloves that last forever. They're a really tight glove. So I'm gonna go and we're gonna start by pulling off our crank arm, and I'm gonna use my ratchet to do this. Replace my other type of Allen. Okay, so I'm gonna bring this over like so. Oh, sorry, 5 millimeter. So what I'm actually going to do is I'm going to grab my set of Allens. And I have a little tray down here. I'm going to take those Allens and I'm just going to kind of set them there. They can kind of go like this if I really want to. Do something like this. That won't need to go there. Bolts. I don't want to take them out. I just want to loosen them. Okay. So now that those are loosened, I have this bearing, this bearing, what we call set cap. So that actually sets the crank arms onto the bearing. And for that guy, we're going to go in our specialty tools. And I'm going to pull out this bottom bracket tool. Okay, this is the BT9, and it actually has the set tool on it. You don't necessarily have to use one of these. You can buy a separate setting tool for this if you have the press fit bottom brackets like this do. These are press fit bottom brackets, but I do have external cut bottom brackets, so that's why this bottom bracket tool is nice to have. Let's see, I got stuff there. Okay. And this will come out. You want to be careful with this because this is made of plastic. Okay, they did it that way because they don't want you to over torque this. They'd rather this break than break a crank arm. So be very careful with that. I'm going to set that aside. Okay. To make sure the pinch bolts are loose. Okay, and you just want to loosen up. And then we have this little, there's a little capture device on that. I got this little hook, and I'm going to use that to grab in here and grab this piece, and I'm going to hook it. Just like that, it just pops up. It doesn't come all the way out unless you take the screws out. That's why I don't take the screws out. And crank arm comes off, as easy as that, okay? Folks, if it comes off harder than that, you got other problems, okay? And then what we're gonna do is I'm gonna get some paper towels and stuff, clean this stuff off. Okay, now, as you can see, our crank arm is loose, and now I can take my rubber mallet, like so, and holding on to the other side, the crank arm, because I don't want the crank arm to go flying. I'm going to knock the crank arm off. Okay, now let's spin her back around so you can kind of see the crank arm. That's how it is now. Loose, and it's out of there. Okay, so now we're going to take and spin her bike back around. And there's gotten a lot of dirt and debris in here. So I take my super dirty cloth. I have a dirty cloth that is covered in oil. And I use that to do my main wipe off where I want to get rid of extra dirt and debris. Okay. And then I'm going to take here, and I'm gonna quickly have to take a bucket or something, put it under me, like so. I'll take and I will wipe down. So I wipe down the shaft itself, okay. We're gonna re-grease it, but I like to get these nice and clean. Make sure these threads are clean on the inside.
I'm gonna wipe any excess gunk and stuff that is built up. This is right now. I'm not worried about aesthetics. I'm just worried about getting major amounts of grease off. And when I mean major amounts of grease, it's mostly what's happened is you get grease on these things, and then you get gunk that builds up on top of it from riding on the road. And especially here where I'm at in Guam. And it just builds up and makes a mess. And then that can chip away at these crank arms. So you want these to last a lifetime, or at least until you have to upgrade them. And that's going to be pretty much everything we do. And then I'll take a little bit more here to them. You want to wipe this one, being careful not to knock this seal out. You have a little seal here. You want to make sure you don't knock that seal out. Keep that seal there. And if I prefer, I'll probably never take the bolts off just because I do not want to lose this capture device here. This little capture spacer. It's really hard to see, but when you drop this down, it's got a little pin in it, and it actually, you have this hole here on the crank set. See that little hole there? And it captures into that hole. So the last thing you really want to do is lose that. It would still stay on there, but that's what keeps it in place. Doesn't seem like much, but it does. So you don't want to lose that. You want to be very careful with these. You know, go ahead and get them wiped off, get them cleaned off, and I'll set that aside for now. If you were worried about, let's say, your pedals, then at that time you could clean your pedals as well. I'm going to pause for a second, grab a couple things, and then we'll be back.